How's it going, guys? Hammond Rodriguez with Pure Image Design here at my mall location at Arizona Mills Mall, making it happen. I'd like to say a big shout out to Swift Car Club for allowing me to take this opportunity to make this happen, but in particular to Jonathan Ralph, who owns this Civic, and in particular this hood. We're making it happen here, guys. We're going to be doing the whole vehicle, and right now we're starting off with this biomech piece that's going to give us the foundation for the rest of the process. So this is part two. If you caught my first video, you can see where I started introducing what we got going on here and some of the attributes to this vehicle's art. But let's start making it happen, guys. We're gonna go in here and we're gonna start picking at the details. What we got here is a lot of lighting effects, a lot of special energy effects. What I'm gonna do here is just plug at them and make them come to life. It's all about action and reaction. You know, the key is to pick up on all the little actions in here and then create the reactions to the action. In particular, we got all these lighting, all this different lighting coming from all these different energy sources, and when there's light, there's reflection. So in particular, we got this, I call it like an energy indicator, and we got the light coming off of that. So wherever that light is hitting, we have to show that reflection indicating the light source. So right here, we have some light coming off of here. And so anything that's next to these objects is gonna be catching that light. So we're plugging away at the truth. And we're making the truth come to life, slowly but surely. Jonathan is really excited about this piece here, as equally am I, because I'm really taking my time with it. You know, I want this piece to be something we can be truly proud of, and you know, the car club community can be proud of, and even the airbrush community can really, really enjoy as we all see this come to life. We're gonna try our best here to get shots of it as it's in process. So every, you know, few days or week, we're gonna get some video of it showing the progress. And I'm gonna just kind of talk a little bit about what I'm doing to give you guys the insight of what's going on in my thought processes. There's a lot of rules that guide me, and we're just talking about those rules. If you guys are airbrush artists, big heads up, I got a how-to article coming out on next issues of Airbrush Action. So all my supporters, please support that magazine. Check out that next issue. It's a great how-to, and I include in that how-to different disciplines and mindsets that guide my art process through a piece like this that you can apply to your own work. A lot of people say, how did I get here? And I have to tell them that I got to this point of in art by having certain disciplines and rules that guide myself through a piece like this. And you have to be true to those rules constantly. Some of those rules have to be with being original. You're not copying others' art, you know. Some of them are rules of lighting, rules of color usage, you know, trying not to use colors straight from the bottle. Or if you're using colors in the bottle, try to do advanced layering and mixing techniques on the canvas. That way your work doesn't look like a box of Crayola 8-color crayons. You know, it's just got red, blue, yellow, and that's it. You know, you wanna have depth, you wanna have richness to your art, and you wanna have identity. You want your work to stand out, and by creating these disciplines or rules, and the more you create, the more identity your work's gonna have, I would say. You know, but as long as you're being creative and you're being precise, you're taking your time, You should be on the right track. Okay, so we're plugging in on our shadow area to define the highlight from the shadow. This is a very important part of developing objects is the relationship between the highlight and the shadow area, and how lighting plays in those two areas. It's all about definition. And in this case, we're in the high definition phase of this piece, where I'm really starting to get in really tight and taking up the detail to a whole another level. I want the viewer to be able to look at this work of art and be set back or set forward at all the detail I've been able to obtain in this piece I'm doing here. Now this kind of style is biomechanical. Bio meaning the skull, the mechanical meaning all the mechanics behind it. H.R. Geiger is probably known as one of the main pioneers for biomech. He did the Aliens movie with Sigourney Weaver. And there was an artist before him that Geiger gives his inspiration to, or inspiration from, which I can't think of the name, but you can look it up, find out. And you could see a lot of influence in Geiger's work from this one artist, which the name just happened to slip my mind, but nevertheless, he kind of was a major pioneer of this biomech. And the cool thing about this is that you can go so many directions with some like this. So many different mechanics in the world today that we can pick up on and apply. So again, we're just plucking at the details. This is all freehand. I use no masks, except for initially I created a light cross that gave me guidance on my middle cross areas, and two lines right here that gave me perfect precision, gave me perfect placement of the middle cross section, as well as two middles out here. So we broke this in three pieces. One, two, three. Allowed me to have points of reference so I can stay right on target in terms of precision and measurement. Other than that, all these lines were created freehand. All this, there's no tape, period. And a lot of people don't believe me when I say that, but I tell you, I don't use any tape. There's nothing wrong with using tape, but I rely on the old-fashioned, craftsmanship of the ages, guys like Michelangelo and Da Vinci, they didn't need all this fancy gadgetry we have today, and I don't need it either, that's one of my disciplines. I want my work to show a lot of technical skill. I want you to be able to appreciate all the effort I put into to work a piece like this. Okay, next, I'm gonna go ahead and start. As you can see, that we have connection areas from the mech into the bio, right here. And what I was doing earlier was I was just, in all these areas that connect from the mech into the bio, I was creating a little bit of rust or residue dripping from those connection areas, just to give this piece more substance, more depth, more interest, whatever you want to call it. Bottom line, it's just more detail what we're doing here. And that's key in pieces like this, or in any piece. People are always going to respect that detail, that fine subtlety that one puts into his work. And it shows all those little dots, textures we're doing, really matter. We're just making this happen slowly but surely, just kind of plucking away. Jonathan has been fortunate, has been nice enough to allow me to take my time with this. That way I can look at it every day with a new fresh eye and just, you know, work away at the details. I'm using an opaque blue, light blue. Right now we're just plugging away all of the reflections. We have a lot of blue lighting, so I'm just adding that opaque blue to all different parts that are catching the light. And this is how we do it. Slowly but surely, we just kind of pluck at it, making sure we do not miss any detail. I like to say I highlight my highlights, I shadow my shadows, I highlight my shadow my highlights. I mean, that's how involved I get with my work. I get in there really tight. I want you guys to be able to look at a piece like this and say, man, you put your time and effort into this one. You know, I want you to be able to respect that. Again, that's one of the disciplines that guides my process. But stay tuned, guys. We got more to come. I'm going to keep you guys posted, part 2. Catch you guys later.